Happily, this presentation is going to touch on a few points that have been raised earlier in the day, which I found interesting. The main one being field versus lab testing. And that's kind of the angle that this arose from. The aim of the research that we carried out was to establish the reliability of performance in simulated sprint distance triathlon. In addition to the reliability of power output during the cycle, and also respiratory and lactate measures as well, to try and kind of create a bit more of a bigger picture of that scenario. Importantly, the kind of reason that this came about, and it's been discussed earlier, is that the simulated performance tests allow the control of scientific conditions just to be able to examine manipulations of performance, some kind of intervention maybe, as opposed to field performance where the control of those conditions is very difficult for obvious reasons, interaction with competitors, topography differences, environmental changes. So the simulations obviously provide some valuable use in that respect. More importantly though, once we've decided to use such simulated tests, the reliability and validity of those tests more important. If you don't know the reliability of simulated performance tests, or the reliability is poor, then we're going to be misinterpreting research findings and potentially misinterpreting tracking changes over time as well if we're using longitudinal study. So just to expand on the background, simulated tests have been used before in triathlon races, and see that there are quite a number of them. But predominantly those have been broken down into several sections of the triathlon. So the cyclotron is a predominant kind of section that's broken down into simulated performance-wise on that. There are also swim cycle studies. But the application of those is obviously limited if we're going to look at the implications of findings in terms of the triathlon as a whole. It's been acknowledged and I'm sure if you believe the triathlon should be complete, considered as a complete endurance effort. Continuous effort in my transition. And as such, there are some research studies that have treated the triathlon as a complete event. But the question still remains whether those protocols are reliable or not, and whether we can interpret the findings accordingly. So, in terms of the methodology of the study, I used non-elite competitive male triathletes. The protocol was reasonably intensive. Some familiarisation work at the start of the period of testing. Incremental tests bookending, so either side of the three repeated simulated triathlon trials, which involved a 750-metre swim, 500-kilojoule workload on the bike, which is equivalent to 20 kilometres, and a 5-kilometre treadmill. So the swim was conducted in the pool, cycle, SRO, ergometer. Cycle and run were both completed in an environmental control room, which is about 70 metres or so from the pool. And there was roughly the same separation between each of those phases of the methodology. A bit more specifically, within each trial, the athletes were required to complete each trial as quickly as possible. Speed and power was freely chosen throughout. Once they left the swimming pool, and then into first transition, they were fitted with a portable gas analysis system, and they then mounted the bike, and then from there on, from the cycle, So it may be suggested that variability is due to potentially residual mechanisms that are present during triathlon or thought to be present during triathlon. So to conclude, simulators with distance triathlon is highly reproducible. Has coefficient variation of performance parameters less than 5%. Physiological measures also have moderate to high reliability. These findings need to really be incorporated in terms of the significance of previous simulated triathlon research, which is an important point. The issue is that findings are being put out there without actually knowing whether they are genuinely real or we are confident that they're real, or whether they're just inherent noise between trials from athletes like them. So future triathlon researchers and simulations should consider or include reliability data. And looking to the future in terms of this research, then obviously the validity of the simulated triathlon is considering. Also the residual effects which might be responsible for the increased variability versus the individual disciplines is something that I'm looking to go forward with. And ultimately, the aim of my research work is moving to is identifying the physiological mechanisms that are involved in fatigue during triathlon, and what distance, ability, intensity, etc. are related to that will have an influence. Thank you.
You would not have.